everyone, Samantha here with Cutting Edge Bullets. This is video number two in our product selection series. Video number one was long range hunting, so ranges out past 600 yards. This is hunting inside of 600 yards, so more traditional type distances. We have a ton of different SKUs, so that's kind of why we came up with this video series, was to help clarify our different product lines and their purpose. I think worth mentioning before we dive into all the different lines is that all of our solid copper bullets all feature our patented SEAL-Tite band. If you're not familiar with the SEAL-Tite band, it is a band slightly larger than caliber diameter, and it encircles the body of each of our bullets. The purpose of this band is to eliminate any gases from escaping around the bullet as the bullet exits the barrel. If you get those gases that escape from around that bullet, it can create inconsistencies and inaccuracy in your shooting. First up is our Raptor line. Our Raptors are all designed to function in the same way. So after about 1 to 2 inches of penetration, you'll get 4 to 6 petals that break off and radiate outward in a star pattern while the base continues. So those petals will actually radiate away from the main wound channel, and I'll actually show some gel blocks so that you can see exactly how they terminally are designed to perform. The number of petals that you get that break off from these bullets depends on the caliber. So for example, our 458 SOCOM bullet will shed 4 petals after about 2 inches of penetration, while the 100 grain 308 flat base Raptor will shed 6. We have the ER Raptor, which is our extended range Raptor, and our FB Raptor, which is our flat base Raptor, but they will all function in the same manner. We have offerings in both solid copper and solid brass. A lot of times we get asked the difference between these two materials, so let's touch on those. Obviously the solid copper bullets are all gonna feature our patented SEAL-Tite band. The brass bullets are all a banded bullet to reduce pressure. The brass bullets typically have a more cleaning effect on the barrel, whereas the copper does not. You will get minimal copper fouling with our copper bullets. However, in comparison to other monolithic solid copper bullets, it'll be nothing like that. This is because of our SEAL-Tite band once again. Our SEAL-Tite band definitely drastically reduces any copper fouling that you're gonna have. Another thing about the brass bullets is that they break up a little bit more violently, so they tend to be good on thicker skin game. The other thing to note is that brass does actually have a trace amount of lead in it, so they are not considered lead-free, and you cannot use them in areas such as California where lead-free ammunition is required. So those are the key differences, but both really excellent bullets no matter what material they're made out of, and some people genuinely just have a preference of one material over the other. Our flat base Raptors are sort of designed more for specialty cartridges like the 300 Blackout, 458 SOCOM, things like that. We do have a few weights of subsonic 308 bullets that will function down to 760 feet per second. The reason I specifically mention these bullets is because people are really surprised to find that we offer a subsonic round for 308. A lot of the bullets in the Raptor series are actually a two-piece bullet, meaning that they have a plastic polymer tip in the end of them. That's just because the hollow points of these bullets are so big that that plastic tip really just helps during flight. Next up is our Maximus line. You might have seen us talking a lot about this line on social media. It's relatively new to our product lineup, and it was designed to be a hybrid between our High BC MTH line, which is our Match Tactical Hunting line, and our Raptor line. So these are all solid copper, all have our SEAL-Tite band.
The Maximus bullet line is designed to expand a little bit differently than the other lines. If the impact velocity is over 2,400 feet per second, they will break into 8 pieces. If the impact velocity is under 2,400 feet per second, they will break into 4 pieces.
This is not a two-piece bullet like the Raptors, so they are a little bit better price point-wise. They also have a higher BC than the Raptor line. So this is a really, really great option for inside of 600 yard hunting. The petals might not be as big as the Raptors whenever they shear off, but it does have a higher BC, which appeals to some people. We really love this lineup of bullets. It's kind of the perfect puzzle piece that was missing from all our product lines. So we definitely encourage people to give them a try. Next up is our Laser line. These are all also solid copper, and they're also a two-piece bullet like our Raptor bullets. So they do have that polymer tip in the end of them. These are gonna shed 3 petals. The gel blocks pictured demonstrate how they function terminally. That base will continue going through while those petals shear off and follow alongside the main wound channel versus radiating outward. And these bullets are higher BC. This line, interestingly enough, is used by a lot of extreme long-range shooters because of their very consistent BC numbers, which is something that's really important when you're stretching it out. So that's just kind of a fun side note about those bullets, but they are excellent for every hunting range. And then last but not least is our MTH line, which is our Match Tactical Hunting line. Now, this is one of the original hunting bullets that we ever created. It is expanding, and it expands similarly to the Raptors and the Lasers, but you get 4 to 5 smaller petals that break off and radiate outward and kind of follow alongside the main wound channel. Once again, you can see the gel block that depicts exactly how they function. You won't get as big of petals, won't cause as much trauma, but they are an extremely high BC bullet, and you can use them for all ranges. So if you're a hunter that doesn't know if you're going to be shooting inside 600 yards or outside of 600 yards, the Laser or the MTH lines are probably your best bet. So that covers all of our different lines for hunting applications inside of 600 yards. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at info@cuttingedgebullets.com. Thanks for watching.